Hello everyone, I'm excited to dive into today's tutorial where I will unleash the power of HTML visuals for Power BI. We will break down how to wield HTML to structure and format text in Power BI without any boundaries. And then we'll jazz up your dashboards with dynamic and interactive HTML cards. But hey, before we get rolling, hit that subscribe button to stay updated with cutting-edge data science and business intelligence tutorials. And here is something special for you. Stick till the end where I will share with you a nifty hack on how to share your Power BI dashboards with anyone without breaking the bank on Power BI licenses. Now, grab a cup of coffee, sit back and watch. Okay guys, while working with Power BI reports, a lot of times you find yourself that you need to add list of texts, and the way to do this either through cards or tables. And one of the main limitations of Power BI is dealing with text. You can't format it much. Yes, you can change the color, but if, for example, if you want to add title and subtitle and then add text, you want to have them in a vertical list, it's a bit limited to do it using the traditional Power BI visuals. Today, we'll try something new. And for that, we're going to use HTML. So let's start by importing the HTML visual. Get more visual and search for HTML. We're going to use this visual, add. Here we go, we have it added. So this visual expects the input to be HTML. Now let's see how we can convert this text to HTML format. First of all, let's delete this table and add the new visual. Now for the values, we're going to use one HTML column that we'll create. I'll show you an easy way to create and format your HTML text. We're going to use this HTML editor. It's an online free editor. I'll leave a link for you in the description. All you need to do is to add the text in the format you want. You have all the format options here. You can use it and it converts this text to HTML format. Let's, for example, keep it at the middle and add our fields. In the next row, I'll have it aligned to the left and I'll add the comments. Then I'll just add a subtitle here. I'll call it risks and issues. And finally, the issues list. So those are placeholders. We're going to replace them later with the actual fields, but let's format them the way we want. For example, let's make this bold, underlined. You can also change the color, but we'll keep this as is. We'll keep the comments in a different color. You can add more colors from here, but we'll use the default ones. Use this, for example. Let's make this title bold. And as a separator at the end, we're going to add a line. You can insert horizontal line from here. Let's keep it simple. I will not do much formatting. You can even insert images, tables if you need, or if you want to use simples, you have all list of simples you can choose from. But again, let's keep this simple for now, just to see how it works. So once we finish the editing and we prepared our fields, you go to edit HTML source code. It gives you the HTML code. All you need is to copy this and we go back to Power BI. And we create a new calculated field, right click, new column. Let's name it HTML text equals, and we treat it as a text. So we need to use double quotes and paste the HTML code and close. But notice here, the HTML code already has some double quotes, and this is why we're getting errors. So we need to find a way to overcome this. And of course, there is an easy way. all you need to do, just use the notepad, paste the HTML code, and all you need to do here, go to edit and select replace, and you just need to find the double quotation and replace it with three double quotations and one double quotation. Click on replace all. So now you can see it's already replaced everywhere. Now we just copy the HTML again and we replace it in the calculated column. Paste. So now we can see we don't have error. And the last thing we need to do, we need to replace the placeholders with the actual fields. And to do this, just highlight it and we'll close the text with double quotation, add and, then add the field, again and close. So this will add the text together. The and here will keep adding the text together. We need also to replace the comments here. And finally, the issues list. And we have our field is ready. Comment. Now all you need to do is just to add the field to the values of the visual. And you can see it comes formatted as expected. And if you select different projects, it filters. However, one last thing. Here you can see that we have the list. We have two items in the list, item 1 and item 2, but they're showing the same line. To overcome this, we are going to edit the issue list field by adding the new line separator. So if you look here, I already added a column from the data source called issues list. And you can see that I separated each line by adding this to start a line and this to close the line. And I repeat when I want a new line, so this is the second line, I add this and I close it by this. This is the HTML code to start a new line. So now if we replace the calculated field we just created with the new field, here we go, this is the field, adding the line separator, hit commit. You can see now each item comes in a separate line as expected. And that's it, you have the text now converted to HTML and you can format it the way you want. So far we saw how to convert text to HTML and we can format it in different ways just using the online editor. But what if we want to have more sophisticated HTML visuals? Something like cards or animated cards that are dynamic and interactive. Is that possible? Let's see. First, let's duplicate this page and let's clear the values. Now, where can we find nice designs for cards? You can easily find them online. You can find online so many libraries for HTML designs. I will provide you a link for this website. It has so many templates for cards and other kind of visuals. You'll find a lot of them dynamic and interactive. Some of them are static, like this one. All you need to do is to find the best design you want from this list. As you can see, as you scroll, there are so many options. Some of them have really nice design and interactive. Once you settle in one of them, you just click on Get Code. So I have one selected already here. I have it open another page. Once you click on Get Code, it takes you to the code page. You can see this card is dynamic and interactive. It has title, subtitle, and the items here. We're going to use it to show our text in a nicer and interactive way. Let's see the code now here. We have HTML tab and we have the CSS tab. It's important to mention here the CSS is very important because this is the code that gives this card the dynamic and interactive feel. So all the style is stored in the CSS code. So the HTML alone will not give you this design. So you need to find a way to combine both codes to one HTML code. And if you're not comfortable with coding this and adding and embed the CSS inside this HTML code, don't worry, I have a trick for you that will help you to do this very easily. And the trick is simply to use ChatGPT. So I have prepared it already. So this is what I requested. I have HTML and CSS as separate codes. Can you combine them into one HTML code? So I provided the HTML code here. You can see I just copied the code and pasted here. And then I provided also the CSS code. So it's inside this container. As you can see, I just paste it as is and send the request. ChatGPT came back with one combined code. You don't need to do anything else but to copy this code. So simply click on copy code. And remember that we need first to replace the one quotation like what we have done in the text editor. The same thing, we're going to use Notepad. I'll just paste the entire code and use the same replace function. Replace all. That's it, we're ready. Copy the output again. We go back to Power BI. Let's create a new column. And I'll call it CSS equals double quotation, paste, double quotation, enter. So we have the code embedded. And we, of course, we need to replace the contents. Just like before, we need to replace the fields. But before we do that, let's see how it looks like. I'll just feed it into the values. And you can see it comes nicely as expected. Let's see after we replace it with the actual fields how it will look like. So we need to replace digital way with milestones and this here, the subtitle with the comments and this with the issue lists. So I'll just expand it again and you'll find the fields here. At the very end, you have the digital way, just like we have done in the text editor. And we're done. We have all the fields replaced. Let's collapse this. You can see now we have the three items added because we have three milestones for this project. You can see once you hover over any of them, the issues will show up. As expected, and as you change the project, the list will be updated. So this is a really nice and easy way to embed HTML texts inside Power BI and to have them formatted as cards and also interactive. You can have so many designs using the different online templates. So if you see here, this is another template I've tried. It will flip when you hover over it and you can change the text with the fields. So that's it. Now you know how to embed HTML cards inside your Power BI dashboard. I hope you found today's tutorial jam-packed with value. If so, show some love, hit the like button, leave your thoughts in the comments. New here, make sure to subscribe to this channel. Now, let me hook you up with a game changer. Data Taco is a platform that allows you to share your Power BI dashboards with anyone hassle-free without the need for pricey licenses. Simply sync your workspace, configure your dashboard, and invite your audience using their personal or professional emails. No Microsoft accounts are needed. No Power BI license is needed. Plus, it's a steal compared to shelling out for Power BI licenses for everyone. And here is the cherry on the top. Snag another 15% discount using the exclusive discount code showing below. So don't miss out. Try it now. Until next time, peace.